Welcome to ECE 3300, Introduction to Electromagnetics. This lecture is lecture number 3. We're going to be talking about traveling waves. There are 3 important factors to remember about waves. The first is that moving waves actually carry energy. They carry power and voltage and current from one location to another. For example, when a ship passes through water and creates a wave, that's really an energy source. You can certainly feel it if you're in a boat near that ship. The second thing to remember is that waves have velocity. They move with different speeds in different media. The very fastest velocity in all of our applications is going to be in air or in vacuum. And the third is to remember that they are linear. They add up. So if I have one wave coming from one direction and another wave coming from another direction, I can find the total field at any location just by adding up or summing these two waves. Now there are several ways that we categorize waves in electromagnetics. One of them is a function of time. So if we put time on this axis, a sinusoidal wave would come in and run something like this. So it'd be a sine wave. A sine wave is also called a CW wave. CW stands for continuous wave. And what that means is that we assume that a sine wave has been going forever. We don't assume that it started at zero and then we saw it coming, you know, from the left side. We assume that that has been going forever. So a sine wave or a continuous wave is sometimes also called a frequency domain wave, because the only thing that we need to know is the frequency and the amplitude, and then the entire wave is defined. Now a second type of wave would be something that changes with time, changes substantially with time, something like a step function from turning a source on or off, something like a pulse, perhaps like this. Maybe another kind of pulse, a spike. Another thing that you might see is a sine wave that then stops. All of these would be called time domain waves because there's going to be a substantial variation with time. Some examples of this would be the electromagnetic pulses that happen because of a large explosion, or turning things on or off, cell phone signals that turn themselves on or off. Those would be typical examples of time domain or pulsed or electromagnetic pulsed simulations. Another way that we can describe waves is in terms of space. There are 3 kinds of waves that we typically talk about in our electromagnetics classes. One, for instance, is a one-dimensional wave. A wave that has only one dimension is something that is going to be continuous in a plane and traveling this way. So this plane right here is going to be copied and copied and copied, and the only variance in this wave is in this one dimension, perhaps in the x direction. This would be typical of waves that are on transmission lines, and it's equally applicable to something that we call plane waves, which we will learn about near the end of our class, near the end of our course. A plane wave is something that is constant in 2 directions, say the y and the z direction, but varies in the x direction. So those would be 1D waves. 2D waves are waves that vary in 2 dimensions. That would be typical, for instance, suppose that I had a current or some sort of source that was linear that went from minus infinity to plus infinity. It's an infinitely long type of system. And then I would see variation in this plane right here. So in this case, for instance, the wave would propagate out away from this current. That would be very much the same as dropping a stone in the water and having the waves propagate out from the stone. So that's a 2-dimensional wave. These are also called cylindrical waves, and typically those are caused by very long wire antennas. An example where you might use antennas like that would be in geophysical prospecting, where you want to be able to find things that are under the ground, and you use a very, very long wire for that. A third type of wave is a 3-dimensional wave. Most of our realistic situations